Hi everyone, I'm Kate with RGG EDU, and today I'm going to show you how to load our Rainforest Action in Photoshop. So first of all, if you've never used Actions before, there are a couple ways to get to our Actions panel. The first one is to click this little arrow over here, and that'll open that up. Or we can go to our Windows tab and down to Actions, and that will open that up there. So you'll see right now that the Actions tab is empty, and we're going to load our first Rainforest Action in there. So to do that, we're going to click our tab here and go down to Load Actions. If you've just downloaded the action, you can check your downloads folder, or you can save them to your own folder. Just make sure you know where they are. So I'm going to go to my folder here and go down to Rainforest and click Open. And you'll see in our Actions panel here now we've got a set, and if we expand that, here is our first action. And so to run this, we just hit our play button here, and we've loaded our first action. So let's delve in and take a little bit of a deeper look on what the Rainforest Action is actually doing here. I'm just going to close this guy so you can see the image. And if I toggle this on and off, you'll notice a couple things are happening. One, we're increasing the saturation significantly. So if you take a look at the greens and the blues in particular, we're adding a lot of depth and richness by increasing the saturation. You'll also notice that her saturation in her skin tone and in her clothing is also increasing. When I designed this particular action, I had in mind sort of a commercial look. To me, that means something a little bit more high key. We bring in that saturation and really make it pop, and then we brighten it to have this light, airy effect. So if I expand this down here, notice that we've got a couple different groups. And we start down here with adding contrast and saturation. And as you can see, each of these individual layers are named, so you'll be able to have an understanding of what each of them is going to accomplish. So for here, we've got balance of luminosity, and what this is going to do is it's going to affect our saturation and the luminosity of the greens. This particular action works really well for any kind of landscape image or something that has a lot of green in it. I know a lot of photographers struggle with greens in particular in imagery, so this is going to have a really nice effect on that. Again, you'll see some layers on brightening shadows, adding some vibrancy and warmth. All of these different layers are going to build up subtly, and then eventually it's going to create this really nice, well-balanced saturation increase and contrast increase. Instead of just taking the hue saturation slider and cranking up saturation, this is going to have a much more subtle effect, and it's going to have a nice, more uniform color consistency. And then basically what I've done is I've duplicated that group just to amplify that a little bit more. And if you look at the image and you say, okay, well maybe this has taken it a little bit too far, you can toggle this on and off. So that kind of backs that down a little bit. We still get the saturation increase and the contrast increase. It's still a little bit brighter, but it's a little bit more subtle than if we had the action running at full speed. I just want to point out too that all of these layers are labeled in a way that you should have a decent understanding of what is happening when you toggle that layer on and off. So if you want to make an adjustment to a particular aspect, you may be able to just go in and scroll through and say, you know what, maybe there's too much contrast in the image, I'm going to turn this off. And that way, even if you don't necessarily know how to use a particular layer or you're not familiar with how curves work, you'll be able to identify through the label of that layer how that is going to affect the image. So you'll also notice a third group here, and this is the fixed screencast group. And this is really great for images like this one, for instance, where we have a lot of green in the background and we have a white or a neutral dress or maybe some skin tones that are directly adjacent to those green tones. And what happens is you get kind of a cast from the green. So I'm going to run this action real quick here. And you see what's happening is in this area, maybe under her arm or in the side of the dress here, we're getting some of that green cast that is kind of a relic of what happens with the action. And so if we expand this and select our fixed screencast layers here, I've masked this out for you so we can paint back in. And if you can take your brush on our white here, and then you can just start to gently paint back in and get rid of some of that green cast here. And so we'll want to go to the skirt area over here, under her arm, she's got a little bit of green. And I'm gonna do kind of a quick job for you here just so you can get the idea, but if you're shooting against a lot of green, a lot of times you're gonna have problems with cast. So I wanted to give you guys the option of being able to manipulate that. We toggle the fixed green cast group on and off. We've now pretty much eliminated the green cast on the dress. This also works great for just a regular landscape shot. If we run this here, this really brightens up the image. A lot of people are really afraid of saturation, and this particular action solves a lot of that problem for you. And it creates these beautiful green tones without looking overly saturated or overdone. So this particular action may not be the best if you have a subject matter that's a little bit more serious or somber. The particular action is really great for like a landscape shot like this that you want to add a lot of life and dimension to. It's great for something more commercial like our cyclist. So if that's the sort of aesthetic that you're going for, this is a really powerful action.